Yes, beta, let's continue with the postulates. First postulate is a straight line may be drawn from any one point to any other point. That means if one point is given and there is one another point, and if you will join that one point to another point, that means one point is here. And I have taken two points. So if you will start from this point, you will get a one straight line from the one point to another point. What does it mean? It means that there is a unique line passing through two given points. Okay. So if two points are given, so in that case, you will draw only one straight line. You can't draw two lines from any two points. Okay, so that means only one line is possible from the two given points. And it is written here, given two points, there is a unique line passing through them. So that means from the one point, only one line, from the two points, only one line is possible. Next is postulate number two, a terminated line. Terminated. What does terminated means, beta? In the first chapter, in the number system, you have listened about the term terminated. Terminated means जो चीज finish हो रही है. आपके पास एक line दे रखी है, terminated line means उसकी एक fixed length है. It can be produced indefinitely. इसका मतलब अगर एक आप actually हम बात कर रहे हैं line की, तो line जो होती है it can be extended in both the direction. So that means if a line of 3 cm is given, then you line segment is given, then you can exceed it in both the direction. So the second postulate is a terminated line can be produced indefinitely in both the directions. Okay. Any doubt, beta? Any doubt? Next is a circle can be drawn with any center and any radius. You all know that if the radius of 5 cm is given, then you can draw a circle. If the radius is 4 cm, then you can draw a circle. If the radius is 3, 5, 7, 8, then you can draw the circle. But the condition is radius and center must be given. Because if the center is given, you can draw any circle of any radius. So a circle can be drawn with any center and any radius. Okay. Next is the fifth postulate. All the right angles are equal to one another. अगर आप कोई भी right angle draw करते हो, चाहे वो small size का करते हो या big करते हो, actually है तो 90 degree ना, तो angles अगर 90 है, तो सारे क्या करेंगे? Coincide करेंगे, means they all are equal. So you please all read out these four postulates, and if you will have any doubt, you can ask me again. I can explain it again. Hurry up, read it out. Yes, there
is. Ma'am, please repeat postulate second.
Second means agar aapke paas ek koi line given hai, actually word hai line. To agar aap koi bhi ek line segment draw karte ho, usko aap dono directions mein increase kar sakte ho, produce kar sakte ho. Ye matlab hai iska. A terminated matlab ek koi small size ki fixed line length ki segment de rakhi hai, to aap usko dono side pe प्रोड्यूस कर सकते हो. कैन बी प्रोड्यूस इनडेफिनेटली. इनडेफिनेटली का मतलब है आप इनफाइनाइट लेंथ तक उसे प्रोड्यूस कर सकते हो.
ये जो पोस्टुलेट वन के नीचे जो है ना,
हाँ जी
मैम, इसका मैं कुछ
समझा की
उसके नीचे जो डिस्टिंक्ट पॉइंट.
हाँ, अगर मतलब आपके पास दो, as you have heard about the parallel lines, if the two lines are parallel, then there is one transversal, then the sum of the co-interior angles on the one side of the transversal is always 180. But here in this fifth postulate, what is written? Aapke paas do straight line hai, two straight lines are there, and there is one transversal. So aapke paas ye jo do lines hai, ye parallel nahi hai, it is not given. अगर ये लाइन पैरेलल नहीं है, इसका मतलब अगर आप इन दोनों लाइन को एक डायरेक्शन में प्रोड्यूस करते हो, कौन सी डायरेक्शन में, जहां पे ये बेंड हो रही है। अगर आप इस लाइन को आगे लेके जाते हो इस तरह से इंक्रीज करके, और इस लाइन को भी आगे प्रोड्यूस करते हो, तो दे विल इंटरसेक्ट समवेयर। यहाँ पे कहीं पे इंटरसेक्ट करेंगे। अगर आप इस लाइन को भी प्रोड्यूस कर देते हो और इस लाइन को भी प्रोड्यूस कर देते हो, तो दे विल इंटरसेक्ट समवेयर एट पॉइंट ऑन दिस लेफ्ट साइड ऑफ दिस लाइन। तो दैट मीन्स कि अगर आपके पास दो लाइंस हैं एंड देयर इज वन लाइन फॉलिंग ऑन दैट लाइन, देन द सम ऑफ द टू राइट एंगल्स, देन द सम ऑफ द टू राइट एंगल्स, टू एंगल्स ऑन दिस साइड विल बी लेस देन 180। Actually, what happened is whenever the lines are parallel, then the sum of the two angles is always 180. But if the lines are not parallel, then we can say that because the lines will intersect somewhere at any point when you will produce, then the sum of these two angles must be less than 180. So you please read out this statement. If a straight line falling on a straight line makes the interior angle on the same side of it taken together less than the two right angles, then the two straight lines, if produced indefinitely, meet on that side on which the sum of the angles is less than the two right angles. Means they will surely meet at that side where the sum is less than 180. Actually, यहाँ पे जो sum है इस angle का, इसका और इसका, इस angle का जो sum होगा, this will be more than 180 because they are, when you will produce them, they will make the sum more than 180 because both the angles are more than 90. So if you will add them, they will surely give you more than 180. But if you will produce these two sides on the left side, then the sum will be surely less than the 180 of these two angles. So that means this postulate shows that if the lines are parallel, then only the sum is 180. Otherwise, the sum will be less than 180 degrees. If you want to read the another version of this postulate, it is given in the things what we have discussed at the end of the chapter on page number. Wait. 88. On page number 88, the another version of this postulate is given. If you want to read that, you can. It is given, sixth point is given. You please read it out. Read it out, please. That is the another version of the fifth postulate. This fifth postulate is fixed. You can change the numbering of any of the postulate, but it's compulsory to learn the fifth postulate at the fifth place because it can be asked in the exam, write the meaning of fifth postulate, yeah, explain the fifth postulate, write the easiest version of fifth postulate. So you can learn this statement and you can explain it in your own words. And if you want to write down, you can write down the sixth point that is given on page number 88. You please read it out. You can explain that also. Is it okay? Any doubt, beta? Now, what you have to do is you have to use these axioms and postulate in your chapter and you have to write the results side by side. Now, the next is theorem number one that is given on page number. This theorem number one is given on page number 85, theorem number 5.1. It is very, very important. I am going to explain it on board. So let me check what other things are there. अच्छा, जो फिफ्थ पोस्टुलेट है ना, प्लीज रीड आउट दिस स्टेटमेंट। देयर आर सेवरल इक्विवेलेंट वर्जन ऑफ फिफ्थ पोस्टुलेट, वन ऑफ देम इज अ प्ले फेयर एक्सियम। जो फिफ्थ पोस्टुलेट है उसका एक और नेम है प्ले फेयर एक्सियम. इट इज रिटन इन योर बुक ऑल्सो. अगर आप इसको रीड करते हो, ये प्ले फेयर एक्सियम नेम जो है ये आपकी बुक में गिवन है. तो द क्वेश्चन कैन कम लाइक दिस, एक्सप्लेन द प्ले फेयर एक्सियम. द प्ले फेयर एक्सियम इज सेम एज योर फिफ्थ पोस्टुलेट. ठीक है. नाउ एज यू कैन सी दैट दिस लाइन इज गिवन फॉर एवरी लाइन एल and for every point P not lying on L, there is a unique line M passing through P and parallel to L. So this is the easiest version of fifth postulate that I am talking about, that is given on page number 88, point number 6. You can please compare it from the book. Please check it out. This statement is exactly same that is given on page number 88. Things we have discussed may given hai, ye wahi statement hai. So keep this thing in mind. The fifth postulate is having one another name that is called play fear axiom, and this is the easiest version of your play fear axiom. So this you will learn. Got it? You can learn this also, or you can learn from the same that is given on page number 82. जो भी हमने देखा था fifth postulate वो भी learn कर सकते. Now today's homework is you will write all the five postulates in your fair notebook, and you will write this point also, that the play fifth postulate is also known as play fair axiom. Is it okay? Any doubt? Now look here. One postulate that you have learned is ये terminated line है. Terminated means जिसकी length fixed है. It can be extended indefinitely. It can be extended indefinitely in both the directions. This is known as your postulate. A terminated line can be extended in both the directions. Got it? Any other thing which is not clear to you? Now, after these five postulates, one axiom number 5.1 is given. Let's understand the meaning of that. That is given on page number 82. This is your axiom. This axiom is given two distinct points. There is a unique line passing through them. Two distinct points are given, then there will be only one unique line that can be drawn from the two distinct points. And one another way is there to represent your aapka jo first postulate tha na, a straight line may be drawn from any one point to the other point. So isi ka hi ye dusra hai. Dono ka same meaning hai. जो आप एक्सियम नंबर 8.1 देख रहे हो या पोस्टुलेट नंबर 1 देख रहे हो, दोनों सेम है. क्या मीनिंग है? कहता है अ स्ट्रेट लाइन कैन बी ड्रॉन फ्रॉम एनी वन पॉइंट टू एनी अदर. और इसमें क्या कहता है आपको एक्सियम में, फ्रॉम द टू डिस्टिंक्ट पॉइंट देयर इट कैन बी ओनली वन एंड वन लाइन. तो दो डिस्टिंक्ट पॉइंट से एक ही लाइन ड्रॉ. इज इट ओके बेटा? एनी डाउट? Now these are the five postulates. Now let's start with the example number 1. So examples are very important, and only few questions are there in the exercise, so you have to give complete practice of those questions so that you can easily solve them at your own. So example number 1 is, it's bahut chote chote questions hai, bas ek hi cheez important hai ki aapne jo bhi axiom ya postulate aap use कर रहे हो, that you have to write side by side. So in the first example, it is written that a straight line is there. A, B, C are the three points. B is lying between A and C. Prove that AB plus BC is equal to CA. This you have to prove. Can anybody tell me This same thing we had discussed yesterday also. Can you tell me which axiom is this? Which axiom is matching with this result? Can you tell me the axiom? Yes, anyone? Axiom number 4. Things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. The things which coincide with one another are equal to one another. तो आपके सामने है ए बी और बी सी कोइंसाइड कर रहे हैं. इफ यू सेपरेट ए बी एंड बी सी दे विल, इफ यू कीप दीज टू स्मॉल पार्ट्स ऑन द बिगर लाइन ए सी देन दे विल श्योरली कोइंसाइड. इज इट? सो दैट मींस इफ द टू पार्ट्स विल कोइंसाइड विद द कंप्लीट लाइन दैट मींस यू आर यूजिंग योर एक्सियम नंबर 4. इट्स नॉट कंपल्सरी टू राइट द एक्सियम नंबर, but it's compulsory to write the axiom. So you will write here, if the two things coincide with one another are equal to, if two things coincide with one another are equal to one another. Okay, this you will just write. And if you want to read it out, you can please read out the solution from a 84 number page. Axiom is written and this result is given that AB plus BC will coincide with AC. That's it. So you have to just write down the result. Okay. Any problem? Now next is your example number 2 that I'm explaining, and I will give you 2-3 minutes to draw it. It is very, very important. You have to draw. The question is, prove that an equilateral triangle can be constructed on any given line segment. आपके पास एक line segment है, but the length is not given. Suppose I have drawn the line segment AB. Okay? आपने इसको देखकर एक equilateral triangle frame कर. What do you mean by equilateral triangle? You all know that all the angles and all the sides are equal. So if I take the compass and if I measure this line, if I open the compass of this line segment AB, then of this line segment AB, I will put arc of this here. AB से आपने यहां से आर्क लगानी है, A से सेम लेंथ की. सेम वे में आपने B से आर्क लगानी है. इस तरह से आपने A से आर्क लगाई AB की लेंथ की, B से आर्क लगाई BA की लेंथ की, एंड गिव इट नेम C. What you will do is, you will join this A, C and AB. This will give you equilateral triangle. Why it is equilateral? Because we have drawn AC is equal to AB, which is the radius. Then in the second step, what we have done is, we have drawn AB is equal to BC. That is again the radius. As all the three sides, AB, BC and CA are equal. Why they are equal? Things which are AB same. So we are applying the first result, first axiom. Things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. So you will write here axiom number 1. You have to write the complete result. So that means all the sides are equal. That means the triangle must be a equilateral triangle. Got it? Please hurry up. Start this. I am waiting. You please all draw this and write the axiom, related axiom, side by side.
Ma'am, isme axiom number 1 kyun lagega?
Things, ye do different things hai, they are equal to the same thing. Things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. So ye teenon aapas mein equal hai. मैं आपको कहूँ ए बी के इक्वल है और ए सी के इक्वल है, तो ए बी सी तीनों आपस में क्या हो जाएंगे? इक्वल. तो उस तरह से. यस ब्रिजेश
मैम, ये याद रखने पड़ेंगे कौन सा एग्जाम है.
हाँ जी हाँ जी, बिल्कुल याद रखने पड़ेंगे. यही तो लर्न करना है इसमें, और तो कुछ है ही नहीं. यू हैव टू लर्न 7 एग्जाम्स एंड 5 पॉसिबिलिटीज, दैट्स इट. एग्जाम में ऐसे भी आता है, राइट एनी 2 एग्जाम, राइट एनी 2 पोस्टुलेट. तो आप लर्न करोगे तो लिखोगे ना. और भी वे में क्वेश्चन आता है, जैसे सपोज करो ये क्वेश्चन है, आपने एक एग्जाम इसमें यूज कर दिया, ये क्वेश्चन 3 मार्क्स का आएगा या 4 का आएगा. ये क्वेश्चन होगा, साथ में लिखा होगा राइट एनी अदर टू एक्सियम अदर देन यूज्ड हियर, जो आपने फर्स्ट एक्सियम यूज किया ना, लीव इट एंड राइट टू अनदर एक्सियम्स। ये तो लिखना ही लिखना है, ये टू नंबर का क्वेश्चन बन गया, साथ में टू एक्सियम्स कोई डिफरेंट देने हैं, उसके टू मार्क्स अलग से, ठीक है? तो ऐसे कोई भी क्वेश्चन आ सकता है। यस, एक्सरसाइज 5.1, क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज ट्रू फॉल्स, रिजल्ट्स आर गिवन, यू हैव टू चेक which one is true and which one is false, and you have to give the suitable reason with that. First is, only one line can be passed through a single point. Is it correct? Rishikesh, Jaspreet, Divya, Deepkirti.
Ma'am, infinite.
Ma'am, infinite.
One point, infinite lines can be drawn. And from the two distinct points, only one line can be drawn. So, this statement first is false. Infinite many lines can be drawn. First, next is, there is infinite number of lines which pass through two distinct points. If two distinct points are there, so you all know that this is your first axiom or postulate. This is your first axiom or first postulate. This is your first postulate. Only one line can be drawn from two distinct points. Yeah, a straight line can be drawn from one point to any other point. So this statement is false. Only one line can be drawn. C part. Yes, listen, beta. I am discussing the first question. Second question is about definition that I will send you today, and you will write those definitions in your field notebook. And tomorrow we will start with the question number 3. So today you will note down the question number 2 definitions in your notebook, and this question number 1 you will do even parts. Third is, a terminated line can be produced indefinitely on both the sides. So yes, it is true. It is your postulate. Next is, if two circles are equal, then their radius are equal. अगर आपने दो सर्कल इक्वल लिए, टू सर्कल हैं, दोनों इक्वल हैं, इक्वल का मतलब है they will superimpose one another, they will overlap each other. That means their radius must be same. So yes, if their radius are same, two circles will overlap each other. If the circles are overlapping, then their radius are equal. So this statement is true. Now can you tell me the fifth part? Is it correct? फिफ्थ पार्ट इज, आपके पास एक लाइन है ए बी जो है वो पी क्यू के इक्वल है, और पी क्यू जो है वो एक्स वाई के इक्वल है. अब यहाँ देखो, दोनों में पी क्यू कॉमन है, तो थिंग्स विच आर इक्वल टू द सेम थिंग आर इक्वल टू वन अनदर. दिस इज योर एक्सियम नंबर 1. तो यस, द स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू, थिंग्स विच आर इक्वल टू द सेम थिंग आर इक्वल टू वन अनदर.